Welcome to the Michigan Golfer Show. Join us each week as we explore the people, the places, and the events that shape our great game.
We're at Riviera Country Club during the round of 32 at the U.S. Amateur with the coach of one of the guys who's in this run. Chris Whitten is the coach at University of Michigan. Tell us what it's like watching your own your player in this match.
Right. Well, we've been lucky to have somebody go to match play 3 years in a row now between Kyle 2 years ago, Nick Carlson last year, and Kyle again. So it's different for me as a coach to be outside the ropes watching them this way, but it's fun. And this match has been back and forth the whole way. So a little bit stressful, but it's great to be in the situation.
Which course is better for Kyle, the Bel Air or the Riviera?
I was not over at Bel Air earlier in the week, but Patrick, our assistant coach who's on the bag, and Kyle both said that they prefer Riviera. Kyle's great off the tee and with his longer clubs, and I think this course gives him a chance to use that a little bit.
Ah, I see. That makes a difference. So with Nick in the semifinals last year, he's out washing. Tell us how the teammates support each other.
Yeah, they're awesome. I mean, team culture is such a big deal for us. And we all know golf's an individual sport, but at Michigan, we make it a team sport in every chance we get. So, Nick was knocked out earlier than he wanted to be, but he doesn't have any other plans than watching his buddy and cheering him on. It's pretty cool.
We're at the U.S. Amateur at Riviera Country Club at the round of 32, and with us is Nick Carlson from the Michigan Wolverines. How are you doing, Nick?
Good. Thanks for having me today.
Well, it's kind of fun watching your teammate play in this round of 32, but you sort of liked the course at Bel Air yesterday.
Yeah, I mean, I like coming out here to support Kyle, and he did it for me last year when I made my run and was out there to cheer me on and do everything he can. And, you know, he's a great teammate and a great friend, so I'm glad I can do it as well. And, I liked Bel Air a lot and just unfortunately couldn't get it done in the medal play, but I'm happy to be here right now.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty cool. And talk about pretty cool. You have one of the world's great courses to play on.
Yeah, I mean, Riviera's special. I hear that of all the tour events that the pros get to play, this is one that they circle every year just because they love the course so much. And I've been lucky to come here a lot of times and walk it and watch it. So it's really fun for sure.
And next year, Nick has a chance to play at Pebble Beach.
Right, yeah. Based on his performance last year, he gets to go back again next year to Pebble. And it's relaxing for him to know that he's in already, because qualifying for the U.S. Amateur is one of the toughest things in golf. And so we hope we have a lot of Wolverines there, but Nick's got another one to look forward to.
I think it's like 7,000 try to qualify.
Yeah, it could be. I just know there's so many good golfers out there now, and each one of those qualifiers is a total grind.
Well, we look forward to the end of this match coming out with Kyle Mueller one up and watching Nick play at Pebble Beach next year.
Yeah, fingers crossed. Go Blue.
Your home course has a lot of exciting things going for it in Ann Arbor, new clubhouse. And we just met the guy who supported that, Richard Postma. And you've got new tees, I think.
Right. Yeah, the clubhouse is beautiful. I mean, we've always had a really nice Alistair McKenzie on-campus golf course, which is great. And now the clubhouse is just as beautiful as the course. And all the people who golf there at U of M, I think, are really enjoying it.